Do not be anxious about anything, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you.
Thank you. And there is one final word that Aaron Holland has asked me to share, and this is also the one they chose for me to preach. So let me share with you from Romans chapter 8, these great words of confidence that there is nothing in this world that will ever be strong enough to separate us from God's love. Romans chapter 8, St. Paul said, "What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us there. So who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, or hardship, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." And this is the word of the Lord. Well, Aaron and Holland, I titled the message for you guys today, "More Than Conquerors." And it comes right out of the text that you've chosen, where we hear St. Paul say, because of God's great love for us, we are more than conquerors. I love this text that you guys have chosen for your wedding day. Just this reminder that as you face the future together as husband and wife, that you don't have to fear anything because you are more than conquerors. It's the promise of God. I mean, think about the promises that we heard here, that nothing will be able to separate you from God and his love. Nothing. St. Paul even puts together this list of things that people might say are stronger than God or could pull you away from God. Famine or nakedness or danger or sword or angels or demons, not even death, he says, can pull you away from God's great love for you in Christ. For that reason, we are more than conquerors. And think about God's strong love. That love is, I want to just say three things that I hope you will remember forever and ever. God's strong love for you, it is changeless, it is unconditional, and it is free. That's the kind of love God has for you. Changeless means it never changes. It's always the same, right? It will always be there for you. Aren't you glad God never wakes up and has like a bad hair day and like just punishes people because he's crabby? That's not the way he rolls. That's not God's deal. God is always the same. He is always loving. He will always be there for you. His love is changeless. And his love is unconditional. That means there's no strings attached. You don't have to behave a certain way or do a certain set of things to get God to love you because he already loves you totally and fully and completely. His love is changeless, it's unconditional, and it is free. Jesus paid the price to give you this gift. When he died on the cross for you, it was the seal of the deal that God's grace and his love and his forgiveness was yours, and there's not another price you have to pay to get. Now you see why you're more than conquerors? Because God's love is changeless, it's unconditional, and it's free. Now here's the cool part. You ready? That's not enough, right? The cool part is that in just a little bit, you guys are going to promise to do the same thing to one another. You're going to make some vows and some special promises to one another. And really, if you just had to sum it up, what you're saying is that you're going to love each other the same way that God loves you. That your goal together for the rest of your lives is to love each other with a love that is changeless, unconditional, and free. You think about what that means. That means together in your lives as husband and wife, your love is going to change. Your love is going to be constant. It's going to be solid. There's all kinds of crazy things that are going to happen in your lives and in your world. There's all kinds of things that are going to change. But the one thing you can always rely on, the one thing you can always count on, is the love you have for one another that comes from the love that God has for you. You get this? Your love is for each other is unchangeable. And it's unconditional, right? There's no strings attached to your love for one another. You don't have to perform or be good or make sure you don't leave your underwear laying all over the floor before she'll love you. You see this look right here? Right? Love is unconditional. You don't have to perform or behave or do something. One thing you will never say to one another is, I love you if. No, that's not the way unconditional love works. You love each other first. And that's the way God loved you. And your love for each other is free. That means you don't have to be anything or change yourself to give it or to earn it. It is just given because you love each other and because God loves you. So you see how you are more than conquerors, not just because God loves you, but because together in God's love and your love for one another, there is nothing that you will ever face that will be able to separate you from Him and from one another. Amen? You are more than conquerors, and that's why we're all celebrating with you today.
You are my day.
Well, the reason we have gathered together today on this beautiful afternoon in the sight of God and His church is to witness and bless the joining together of Aaron Joseph Lauzon and Holland Dawn Burton of Holy National. Marriage is an honorable estate which God Himself has instituted and blessed, and by which He gives us a picture of the very communion of Christ and His bride, the church. It is God who has both established and sanctified marriage, and it is He who has promised to bless therein all who love Him and trust Him, and who seek to give Him their faithful worship and service for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now the union of husband and wife, heart, body, and mind, is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in good times and in bad, and when it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture in knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into inadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God Himself. So, Aaron and Holly, here you are.
It's your day.
It's finally come. Here you are. Marrying each other with God our Father and these your dear family and friends as your witnesses. And you're doing so because of the deep love and commitment that you have for one another. And you're doing so with your promise to each other that your marriage will endure with God's help for the rest of your lives. Therefore, I ask you, Aaron, will you have Holly to be your wedded wife, to live with her after God's ordinance in the holy estate of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain with her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Will you have Aaron to be your wedded husband, to live with him after God's ordinance in the holy estate of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, remain with him as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. These wedding rings serve as the symbol of the beautiful promises and vows which you have just so beautifully spoken. These rings are the outward sign of an inward and invisible love that binds your hearts together. As rings are without edge or seam, they have no beginning and no end, so they symbolize a love like yours that will also never end. And as they are made of the earth's finest materials, so your love is of the richest of spiritual values and will always be there for whom you need it most. So would you bow your heads as we bless these rings?
Bless these rings, our Father, to be the visible signs of the vows and promises here made, so that each who wears a ring and each who gives one may always be reminded of their promises, evermore living and growing in the spirit of your love. Receive this ring as a pledge and token of wedded love and faithfulness. Aaron, receive this ring as a pledge and token of wedded love and faithfulness. And now may the giving and receiving of these rings always be a symbol of the faithful and unselfish community of goods that you as husband and wife will cultivate without ceasing. And may they always be a reminder of the excellent Christian virtues with which you will adorn your marriage. To this end, may God bless you through the heavenly bridegroom, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now if you look at those hands with those beautiful new shiny rings that almost didn't go on. These hands are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, holding yours on your wedding day, as you both promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These hands are the hands that will work alongside of yours as together you both build your future. These hands are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with just the slightest touch will comfort you like these hands are the hands that will hold whenever fear or grief racks your heart. These are the hands that will countless times wipe tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of great joy. These hands are the hands that will one day tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will always help you hold your family together as one. These hands will give you strength whenever you need. And finally, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a simple touch. Today, God has blessed both with these hands, these hearts, and these lives. Amen. And now, for as much as Aaron and Holland have consented together to be united in marriage, and for as much as they have pledged themselves to one another and have declared the same before God and all of you, their family and friends, I now pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. What therefore God has joined together, let no one ever put asunder. And now may the Almighty and gracious God abundantly grant you both his favor and bless you with the blessings given our first parents in paradise, that you may both always please him in both body and soul until your life's end. Amen. Well, at this time, Aaron and Helen are going to do the tie of three cords together, three separate pieces of rope that are united as one, symbolizing the two of you and how God has also promised to be a part of your lives together as well. So please go ahead. And as they do that, I'm going to read a poem for you that was written by Holland's mom. It's entitled, Our Song. Jesus, you saw our hearts, the need for love. Hand holding hand, your love brought us here and gently sings over us. Jesus, you are the love song, the strong chord we braid our love around, and you sing over us. Your song in perfect strain lifts us to places where kindness, patience, and forgiveness rule, and you sing over us. The lyric of our song speaks your word, true and sure. It keeps the focus of our eyes on your design for us, while you sing over us. So Lord, keep our eyes, our ears, our hearts attuned to your love song, so that as we go, our union tells of your love as your love sings over us. Church to live their life always confessing you as their Lord. and may they, through days of happiness and sorrow, be always drawn closer to you and to each other, even to the fulfillment of all your promises in Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we join together now in the prayer Jesus himself taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. And now before we close with the benediction and processional, Aaron and Helen have asked me to let you know that they're not going to have a receiving line here in church. They'll greet all of you and be able to say hello and share hugs with you at the reception so that they can get right on with the pictures after the wedding. All right, now, Helen and Aaron, having made those beautiful promises, having been reassured again of God's love and grace and strength and power in your lives, we pray God's richest blessings to you as husband and wife. And as you walk out the doors today, newly married, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. Always. Amen. Well, I imagine there is just one thing left to do. You may kiss each other for the first time as husband and wife.
Yes, the sound of this race.